persevered. Grateful to be working at all. Every day at the mill was the same. But that was about to change.
Manufacturers who bought the clothes never knew. They turned away. But the clocks knew. The ones that worked for them.
We saw everything.
They did nothing.
Nothing!
The weavers are insignificant.
Insignificant.
Their hours must be increased to achieve a rise in productivity.
Yes!
We must make it clear to them that their work rate is simply unacceptable.
Yes!
Labour output must be improved or their wages will be cut.
Yes!
My days at the mill were filled with loneliness and boredom, waiting for something, but I didn't know what. I would spend my days watching the clock, watching the minutes and the seconds pass by. I was never allowed to go to the factory, as much as I longed to see the beautiful cloth being made. To me, it was like magic. Weavers crafted the most beautiful cloth in the world. All I ever did was sit in that office and watch the clock. But then that all changed. It was strange we have a simple factory, one can make me feel so alive. He's brave and strong, and I knew he had a good heart. As much as I longed to stand by him, I knew that I didn't belong in his world, and he certainly did not belong in mine.
nothing like you.
She is poor and has nothing to offer.
And if your father finds out, he will never forgive you.
But I didn't care, for I believed in him. And I would do anything to make him see that I was more than just a spoiled manufacturer's daughter. I heard you're going to do something about it.
So that's it. You're here to hand us in. To ruin our hopes and dreams.
No, I just wanted to help.
Help us?
Yes.
Have you heard about the latest injustice?
No.
Us weavers are being refused payment for one of the most important threads used in our cloth. It is so delicate, so fragile, it's almost invisible to the eye. The smart shot, we call it. Without his strength, the whole cloth would just fall apart.
If you raise this with my father, I'm sure
no.
he would...
There is no point. They have no interest in us, and he will not listen.
Maybe if I talk to them first, I'll tell them about this smart shot, and then we can arrange to make him discuss the way forward. You listen to me. And if they don't believe you, I'll stand by you. I'll tell them I see it.
You will?
Of course I will, Jack. I believe in you.
Oh, it's close.